Okay, then let's move on with the immunity or susceptibility, because as I said, EMC can be split in two big branches. Immunity is the second one. So why is immunity important, or it gets more and more important in the future? Well, also pretty obvious, the channel length is decreasing. Okay, what's the channel length?
The length of the gate of the resistor.
Yeah, so in the CMOS designs, usually we have a drain area, a source area, and the distance between the drain and source is usually called the channel length. So when I started IC designs, we had 350 micrometer. What's the channel length today of modern processor technologies?
28.
Four. Yeah, 4 nanometer, 7 nanometer. So you can see over the last 20 years, the channel length has significantly decreased. So meaning that we are now able to squeeze more and more transistors in a certain area. And also the supply voltage has decreased over the last year. So when I started doing my first electronic designs, all the ICs were supplied by 5 volt. What's the internal core logic voltage today? I don't know, 600 millivolts or something. So also the supply voltage has decreased. And unfortunately, this leads somehow also a little bit to the effect that devices are getting more susceptible. Not in general for all interferences that can happen, but for this RF interference or electrostatic discharges, usually we are causing more troubles because it's not, let's make it this way. There is not that much energy needed to generate voltage interferences within the chip and exceed the threshold level to switch a transistor in a state where it should not be. On the other hand, modern technologies, they usually also, or sometimes also get more robust against radiation hardener, radiation, for example, because the gate area is not that big anymore. So the likelihood that a charge is really that the radiation particle, or whatever we'll call it, is really hitting exactly this gate is not that big anymore. And then there is also not that much volume in the gate, so the charge can be accumulated. So very often with modern technologies, the things are getting better. So this was at least the case the last years, but not for all things. So for RF interference or for transient disturbances, the situation can get more critical. Yeah, so on the one hand, we have, from the EMC perspective, more electromagnetic emissions generated in higher frequency ranges. And on the other hand, we have less immunity. And this definitely leads to more and more EMC problems. So therefore, it's not that unobvious that 70 to 90% of all the designs are failing first time EMC testing.